Hi, this is Professor Lipuma of the New Jersey Institute of Technology, recording from my technical communications class, drawing on material from my text, Fundamentals of Undergraduate Education and Learning. This is the second part going beyond the general discussion of goal, target, and situation leading to package, and looking at specifically the idea of considering MIMES. Now, the first thing you want to think about is, as the sender, you have to look into your own mind to understand what it is that your goal is. And the questions that help you understand your goal deal with MIMES. As you make your package, thinking about MIMES should help you begin to develop a good understanding of what can go into that package. So the first thing, of course, M, message. What it is you're trying to convey, what it is you want to say to the person or group that you are targeting. Now, the next thing we want to think about, the I, is intent. What is your intent? What are you intended to do? And this can both mean who it's intended for, the target, or it can also mean what you intend to accomplish, meaning do you mean to persuade, convince, inform? There's a number of different things with intent. Now, the next M really talks about your means or your method of delivery and your medium that you have available. What resources do you have such that you can put this into effect? If you have no money, you can't send something FedEx. And so these ideas of means are very important. Now, these first three ideas, message, intent, and means, are very difficult to do separate from understanding these other things that you want to get from tribe. And so many times, as you gather more information about your message, you then change your message as your intent changes. And they work together as you look at what means you have. You can't make a video presentation if you don't have a video camera, even though you know that that would be the most effective way to get your message across in order to convince someone. So as these work together and you think about your target, you can do it. Now, the idea here, though, is that beyond this, you have something called end result or the end you hope to achieve. This is a very immediate, short-term, directly related to your message and the package you create. One of the most important things to separate out is that for many times, people think about the end result as the big picture goal. This is the objective of the small thing you're making. An example of this might be your resume. The message for your resume is, I have the skills you need and I'm worthy of being discussed with, talked to, interviewed. Your intent is to persuade and inform. The means is usually a written document sent with a cover letter to a group of targets, either individually or as a group. And your end result of that shouldn't be to get a job. For you, the idea, the end result of this package is to have them call you, to ask for an interview, to ask for more information. The idea of getting a job is really success. The idea here is that success for this situation would be that you eventually get the job, but there might be three or four other sets of packages, some that include you in an interview, others are other documents, recommendation letters, things that you don't even craft. But all of that goes into your ultimate thinking about success, because for now, this package is one objective in the larger scheme of your goal. So hopefully these questions will begin to help you understand what we're doing. And as we look at specific rhetorical situations, you'll begin to see how they apply to what we're doing.